Douglas and honorable guests. This speech is not easy for me, so please bear with me. I believe that my life so far has happened in three stages. Stage one was me connecting to my mind. Stage two was me connecting to my body. And stage three was me connecting to my heart. So, stage one. Little girl with the blue, with the green eyes was born in a tiny Ukrainian town on the border with Romania. She had no idea she existed, and one day she woke up. She woken up and she saw her image in the mirror that was shown to her. Her eyes was full of tears. She had newly pierced her ears, and she had brand new earrings in her ears. And that's the first time when I realized that was me. Looking into the mirror. And so my life was wonderful in my little tiny town with my extended family. Everybody used to adore me. They thought I'm the most amazing creature in the world. At least I was made to feel that way. And my most memorable part of that, my childhood, was my granddad's garden. He had this amazing, immense garden with lots of just anything you could think of. It was like Garden of Eden. We had our playhouse. Everything you could think of grew in that garden, and we used to get lost in that garden. We had our swing. I had the most fun memory of me being spending time in that garden with my younger brother, and also my grandma's village, where she had huge allotment, which I was encouraged to attend to my detrimental, I wasn't very keen doing that. At school, I was really good. Again, I was confident and I was called fat, so I wasn't very body confident. I wasn't fat, so at school they recognized that I'm a leader, so I was sent to specialist leadership camps, and we would have to put up, say, an entire program for an entire day and compete with each other and prepare stage coaching, lifestyle kind of events. It was really amazing. And so then I was doing really well. And I finished the school and I went to study pharmacy. That was a great time. And that was the most fondest memory of my lifetime up until my 21st. When I was 21, my dad suddenly died from cancer, and everything seems to be just went falling off at that point. And that was when my body woken up. And the way I say, because I could see that my dad, he was absolutely healthy, and he suddenly lost his life. And 15 months later, my son was born. He was gravely, severely ill. And 15 months, sorry, over 2 years, sorry. Over 2 years it took to make him healthy, sorry. I didn't plan this. Anyway, eventually he was eating, he ended up being mentally aware, and my mom was helping him. I'm really sorry.
You're fine.
Then I had an opportunity to come to England, and I came to England. My mom was with my son, he was better then. And I studied and I worked really hard. And I became manager in the health shop. So sorry about this. And that was a triumph of the body. I had cervical cancer, I survived that. I was on my own. And I was very strong and I did my best and it paid off. And then stage three, when I connected to my heart, I met another lovely man because I was married to my son's father before. We have a lovely family, and my little baby is 21, going to be next week. Mm-hmm. So he's a junior, he's doing really well. I have a wonderful 12-year-old son, and last 2 years, that was my connection to my heart because I went into self-development. I've learned a lot about how to help myself and how to help other people, and And so now I really enjoy helping women to get connected to their mind, body, and soul, and to their heart, and really make them aware that they're just absolutely the best as they are, and they can develop as much as they can. And so me connecting to my heart, that stage really happened when I went to Mark Atram, $1 Million Mindset, and it was more than 1,000 people in the room, and he really changed my perception about money. So I just thought, well, what do you give to the man who has everything? So I have a drawer in my house where I put all the presents that I've given people. So I picked up a wooden heart, and I've given to Mark Atram in front of the whole audience. I actually gifted that wooden heart from all of us because he was really helpful. And I found myself standing in front of more than 1,000 people at the time, and everybody had connected in that moment to, because I was gifting from everyone. So everybody had connected, everybody stood up, and everybody thanked him from the stage, because a lot of things worth more than money. And that was a really amazing moment, because suddenly I lost my anonymity. My action was really audacious. And I felt a sense of purpose, and I felt that's what I like to do in the future. So, and yes, yeah, so I'm so sorry.